After the disastrous retreat to Corunna, the rifles were reduced to a sickly skeleton. Out of perhaps 900 of as active and fine fellows as ever held a weapon in the field of an enemy's country, we paraded some 300 weak and crestfallen individuals. I myself stood the third man in my own company, which was reduced from near 100 men to 3. After a while, some of the strongest and smartest of our men were picked out to go on recruiting service and gather men from the militia regiments to fill our ranks. I recollect that I succeeded in getting the first recruit, a strong, able-bodied chimney sweep named John Lee. This fellow, whose appearance I was struck with as he sat in the taproom of the Red Lion, offered to enlist the moment I entered the room, and I took him at his word and immediately called for the Sergeant Major for approval. When on the recruiting service in those days, men were accustomed to make as gallant a show as they could, and accordingly we both smartened ourselves a trifle. The Sergeant Major was quite a beau in his way. He had a sling belt to his sword like a field officer, a tremendous green feather in his cap, a flaring sash, his whistle and powder flask displayed, an officer's pelisse over one shoulder, and a double allowance of ribbons in his cap, whilst I myself was also as smart as I dared appear with my rifle slung at my shoulder. We found that the volunteering of the Leicester militia had commenced, and that 125 men and 2 officers had given their names to the 7th Fusiliers. The appearance of our rifle uniform and a little blarney so took the fancies of the volunteers that we got every one of them for the rifle corps. I may say that for 3 days and nights we kept up the dance and the drunken riot. Every volunteer got 10 guineas bounty, which, except the 2 kept back for necessaries, they spent in every sort of excess till it was all gone. Then came the reaction. The drooping spirits, the grief of parting with old comrades, sweethearts and wives, for the uncertain fate of war.